it's Jessie B, and today's video is really, really freaky because it's true, but it's also not true. I know that doesn't make any sense, but part of what I'm gonna be talking about is a real thing. For example, the website we're about to go on is completely real, okay? But the story behind it may or may not be, but the story for sure is scary, so get ready. We're gonna be talking about a website called thispersondoesnotexist.com. You probably have not heard of this website before, and if you have, you know it's kind of scary. I definitely had not heard about this website until I did research for this video, so prepare yourselves. Before we get actually into this video though, I do want to remind you, if you would like to win this background behind me, it's like peaches slash oranges, whatever the heck it is. If you would like to win it, all you have to do is be subscribed to this channel, have your notification bell on, and then go and subscribe to my other channel called VVlogs. I will link it down below in the description. And then go to the video titled Meet Our Turtle and go and comment a really cute name for a turtle. That's all you have to do, then you're entered, and in a couple weeks I will be announcing the winner. So yeah, with that said, let's get into this video. Now, like I said, this website is completely real. And if you go on it, the first thing you see is a person's face. And that's all the website is. It's a person's face just like sitting there looking at you. It doesn't necessarily look scary. I mean, you definitely get a very eerie feeling, but it's just a human being's face looking at you. Now, the creepy part about this website is that the person you're looking at doesn't exist in real life. And what you do is you keep refreshing the page, and every time you refresh, you see a different person's face on the screen. This person totally looks like a human being, but they don't exist. And this might sound confusing to you guys, but basically what happens is this website has a program where it goes all over the internet, Facebook, social media sites, literally everywhere you can access on the internet where people have faces, and they'll take someone's eyes, someone's nose, someone's mouth, cheeks, hair, wrinkles, and it'll mix it all up and create this new person that looks like a real person but doesn't exist in real life because it's just made up of everyone else's different facial features. Do you know what I mean? And when you first hear about this, it sounds pretty cool, right? But I guess this site could kind of have downsides because people can use this site easily for catfishing because they're choosing someone's face that doesn't actually exist. So the real person would never be able to catch them, right? Because it's not a real human. So you're probably wondering, where does the scary part comes in? Well, someone posted a story to No Sleep, which is on Reddit, and they talked about their experience with this website, and what I read really freaked me out, so I'm gonna read it to you guys right now. This was posted by Darwin underscore Demon, which is a very scary username, but like, you do you. Basically, he says that he stumbled across this website, and it really fascinated him, and he sat there for hours and hours refreshing the page, looking at all of these different faces. Now, I'm probably going to sum up this story faster than it actually is. So if you want to read his whole entire story, it is on No Sleep on Reddit. But anyways, like I said, he sat at his computer and was just so interested in this website, kept refreshing the page, and he says that he was intrigued that this whole thing was AI generated and that there was almost an endless possibility of faces, because think about how many people are out there that take pictures of themselves and put them online. I mean, you can make an endless combination of people's eyes, people's noses, people's mouths. So as he was sitting there looking at this website, he refreshed the page again, and staring back at him was his face, his exact face, his eyes, his nose, his mouth, his cheeks, his hair. He says, "At first I thought for sure it was a coincidence, but then I noticed that the face had the exact mole that I had on my face." He says, "Everything about that face was the same as mine, and it was smiling back at me." He says that he freaked out right away, but he was trying to convince himself that it was just an accident. I just realized I've been calling this person a he this whole time, but it could easily be a girl. I don't know why I thought he. It says that he or she got out of their room and walked up to their boyfriend. So it could literally be a man or woman. I don't know. Darwin sounds like a guy though, right? Okay, I checked out their profile more and found out it was a girl. So I'm so, so sorry. It's just hard to know, like, when you just see a username, right? Anyways, let's continue this story. So she sees her exact face on her computer screen. She freaks out, thinks it might just be an accident. So she walks out of her bedroom and sees her boyfriend sitting on the couch just looking at his phone. So she walks up to him, sits down beside him, puts her head on his shoulders. She wants to feel comforted by him because at the moment she's totally freaked out. But what was weird is that her boyfriend didn't react to her being there. He didn't look at her. He wasn't responding when she was talking to him, and she couldn't understand what was wrong with him. Suddenly, there was a knock at their door, and he gets up, walks over, and he opens the door to this beautiful woman. She walks into their house, they kiss. She's obviously completely heartbroken by seeing this. So then she decides to take out her phone and look through her text messages, her image gallery, and there's nothing there. There's no text, there's no pictures of her, of her family, nothing on her phone at all. So she thought this whole thing was just a prank. She says, "I went up to him, shook him, and said through my sobs, 'I know it's a prank, I'm crying now, please stop it.'" And she says, "The one thing he would never let me do is cry." So when he wasn't even reacting to her crying, she knew for sure that it wasn't a prank. She started to question if she even existed anymore, and suddenly she couldn't even remember her own name. And she's saying that she's basically posting this story on Reddit to reach out for help and to tell people the story of what happened to her. I guess it's kind of a warning about this website that if you go on there and you keep refreshing the page, eventually you will end up being on it as someone who does not exist, which is so creepy. But you have to keep in mind, this is a no sleep story, so this is just a fictional story. Regardless though, it really freaked me out and it made me want to just talk about this weird website with you guys. I think, like, scary story aside, this website is kind of genius because literally every single face you see is someone who doesn't exist in this world. It's like a bunch of facial features all together in one. Anyways, so the people who made this website obviously had nothing to do with that story, and they just created it with the intention of making this cool AI program that can create faces of people who aren't actually real. So I do think it's a really cool website, but it's also really eerie, and I think I would like to eventually make a series talking about websites that have this creepy effect on people. So if you like this whole, like, weird website thing, definitely give this video a thumbs up and I can make more. If you would like to check out that website, totally up to you. Do it at your own risk. But yeah, I thought that was pretty fascinating, and yeah, hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I know it's kind of like short and quick, but I had to share it with you guys. So yeah, I hope you have an awesome rest of your day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!